love Jesus because he first loved me. And so I encourage you to be a part of this show today. If you'd like to talk about your life in Jesus, your life without Jesus, you'd like to talk about your life, like to have us pray for you. You may say, well, why in the world would I want you to pray for me? Who are you? Well, I'm a pastor, but that doesn't qualify me to pray for you. What qualifies me to pray for you is that before I started this show, I claimed the scripture where it says, if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. So I have been cleansed from all unrighteousness. That's why I qualify to pray for you. Good afternoon. You're on the Wiley Drake Show. Can we help you?
Yes, actually, I am calling from Cortland.
You're calling from...
I'm calling you from Cortland in New York.
Cortland, New York. All right. What can we do for you?
I'm actually calling because recently a newspaper article was put in showing that my county was the highest foster care county in the state. By 3 to 4 times high.
Now, what is the name of the county?
Cortland County.
Are you saying Cortland, like in court, C-O-U-R-T?
It's C-O-R-T-L-A-N-D.
Okay, Cortland County, and you said your county is the highest number-wise for foster families?
Foster children.
You're talking about
foster children.
You're talking about children that have been taken away from families by CPS and so forth.
Yes.
Or I don't know what you call it there. In California, we call that CPS, Child Protective Services. And so Cortland is very high. And what are your conclusions from that? Why do you think that is?
Oh, because they are willing to take children for anything they can to make money.
Well, ma'am, it's not just...
anything from derivative neglect to alcohol abuse.
Yeah. Well, ma'am, that's not only true in Cortland, and I don't doubt that yours is not high, maybe higher than most, but that's the name of the game all over our nation. We started back some time ago on this television program and on this radio program with what I call an expose of CPS and Family Services. And what we found out was that Mr. Santorum and Mr. Newt Gingrich introduced Title IV, D, and E back many years ago. They did it all under the auspices of doing what's best for the children. Nothing could be farther from the truth, because what they do is they take those children under the auspices of, as you said, maybe there's a problem. There are some children that probably should be protected, should be taken away. But even when the families go through what they're supposed to do, jump through all the hoops, the counties and the states do not want to give the children back. Because if those children are normal children, they're getting more than $1,000 per child per month. If, for example, they are special needs children, that is, a psychoanalyst says, oh, that kid's a little slow, that kid needs help, now they get $2,000 a month for the kids. And so, obviously, there is no incentive for them to give the kids back to the parents, because if they do, they lose money. So it's a matter of money. It's a matter of dollars and cents. Not cents, but dollars. And so we know that's the case. And what we're asking people to do is, it's a very frustrating position. First of all, I'm not an attorney. I am a pastor. But there have been a number of families that have agreed to allow me to be their pastor. And that does a couple of things. Number one, it gives legal protection for me and for the family. Because at that point, once I become your pastor, there is a legal term that kicks in, and it's called priest-penitent privilege. And that is, the courts or nobody can tell me I must tell them anything you or your children tell me, because I'm a pastor and that gives me priest-penitent privilege. So that's step number one. Step number two is, there's very little over the last few years that has been able to be done We do have one case here in California where a family won over $10 million in damages because the CPS Family Services went in without a warrant, took the children away, et cetera, et cetera. And we were able to win that one. But that's few and far between. Typically, the judges, typically the courts, do not want to hear these cases. And they think these workers are doing what's best for the children. However, the most liberal court in the land, the Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals, here in California, has ruled time and time again that that's not the case, that there's a financial incentive, and indeed the children are more likely to be abused by the system than they are even in a terrible situation. So what do we do about it? It seems like almost a hopeless, helpless situation. But what we do on this show is we ask people, that is moms and dads and aunts and uncles and grandpas and grandmas, we ask them to give us the names. You have given us your county name, but we would ask you and others in similar situations to give us the names of the judges, to give us the names of the counselors, to give us the names of the so-called public defenders that we call public pretenders. They're the attorneys that make money and are assigned to a family to, quote, represent them, and they don't represent them. They just get the money. And so we ask for them. I'm sorry?
I can absolutely give you all of those.
Well, here's what I would like for you to do.
She said this is New York.
This is in Cortland, New York, right?
Yes.
Yes. Okay, all right.
If they want to follow the address on the screen, they can check out everybody involved in this.
Okay, we're going to be putting some information up on the screen in reference to New York. But here's what I would like for you and anyone else to do. I'm going to give you my assistant's name and her telephone number and her email. And I would like for you to set. Do you send emails?
Yes.
I would like for you to sit down at your email and write up your story as detailed as you can and send it by email to us so that we have a record of what is going on. And again, the more information you can give us, the better off we are and the better we can help. But we're not attorneys. I'm sorry?
Yes. I understand that, but I would also like to let you know, Bill Windsor of Lawless America.
Yes.
He has a website, lawlessamerica.com. He is currently doing a 143-day tour across the country collecting these stories on corrupt family courts.
Well, I do know of him, and you said the website is lawlessamerica.com, right?
Yes.
I was just looking at his website earlier. We are collecting these stories. We'll share them with him or with anyone who will do what they can to help you. But in all honesty, it's one of those kind of things where many years ago I was taken into court because I would not get rid of homeless people in my church, and I didn't have money to hire an attorney, so I made it clear to the city here that I didn't have any money to fight them, but I did have the public on my side, and we took it public and did achieve a lot. Now, I'll give you, and anyone else is welcome to take this down. My assistant's name is Corey, C-O-R-I, C-O-R-I, and her last name is Harkins, H-A-R-K-I-N-S, Corey Harkins.
Mm-hmm.
And her email is Corey Harkins at yahoo.com. Very simple. Corey Harkins at yahoo.com. And her phone number is 714-470-9225. Now, I'll say up front very quickly, there's very little in worldly terms that we can do for you. But Corey is a prayer warrior. She's a godly woman. I'm a prayer warrior. We can pray for you. We'll be glad to counsel with you at any time and talk to you. But the bottom line is, we can only compile your story. You get it to us. We'll make it available. What's the gentleman's name at Lawless America?
Bill Windsor.
Bill Windsor, yeah. And I was talking, not with him, but with someone else today, and we will share with him. And Bill, if you're listening, all you got to do is ask us. We'll be glad to share with you. Ma'am, can you hold on just a minute? I believe I have another caller on the line. Caller, are you there? Do we have a caller on 559?
Hey, guys, hello.
Go right ahead, caller. Who are you?
My name is Felix Lewis. Calling you from Los Angeles.
From Los Angeles, okay. Go right ahead with your call. Speak up if you would, please. I'm having a little trouble hearing you.
I'm having a hard time hearing you guys.
Okay, well, go ahead. I can hear you. Okay, now, go ahead and tell us what's your purpose for the call.
You guys actually called me. I'm calling in.
And who is this?
My name is David. Last name is Wood.
David Wood. And why did we call you? Do you know?
One of your producers called me this morning.
Okay, did you call it? Well, my producer's shaking her head no, but what's it about, David?
We're working on a movie called The Resurrection.
Called The Resurrection. You must have talked to our producer down in Georgia, Bob Bosworth.
There you go.
Yeah, okay. All right. Well, tell us about your movie. Tell us the title of it. Tell our friends how they can find out more about it. What's it about?
So it's the 3 days of Jesus coming out of the tomb. It takes place right after Mel's Gibson's The Passion of the Christ stuff.
Okay. So it's called The Resurrection.
Yeah. You can go to a couple websites, myresurrectionproject.com. Or theresurrectionproject.com. You can see where we're at and what's going on with it.
Okay, so it's myresurrectionproject.com.
Yeah.
Or the other one?
Resurrectionproject.com.
All right, resurrectionproject.com. Okay. So it's resurrectionproject.com or myresurrectionproject.com, and we can find out more about the movie called Resurrection.
Yes, sir.
All right. Well, we certainly...
We're shooting in Israel. It's going to be a wonderful film about love and hope. I believe the world is in great need of right now.
Well, you're absolutely right, my brother, and we will be more than happy to help you promote it, especially if it's about the resurrection. That message needs to be out to all the world. If you will, let me give you a couple of emails. If you will email me information and get information to me, we do 2 one-hour television and radio shows every day, Monday through Friday. Let me give you my other producer's number and name here in California. Her name is Corey, CoriHarkins, Corey Harkins. And her email is CoreyHarkins@yahoo.com. Her phone number is 714-470-9225. You get that information to her, and we'll be glad to help you promote it any way that we can. And we thank you for calling. And we'll put these websites out. Get us any information in our hand that you can get to us or get to Corey via her email. Her phone number is 714-470-9225, and you can call her. She is my personal assistant and producer here at the show in California. And your name is David Wood, is that right?
Yep, that's right.
All right, and we go to resurrectionproject.com or myresurrectionproject.com. And you said some of this is going to be shot in Israel?
Yeah, most of the film will be shot in Israel. There's a great movement of God. It's hopefully going to unite the church globally, and we're very excited about it.
Well, brother, we want to help you do that. We are excited about the project. In all honesty, I had not heard about it. I do have another scheduler and a producer that's down in Georgia, Bob Bosworth, but he's been having some computer problems and some phone problems, so he had not made me aware that he had already contacted you. If you will email me, let me give you my email as well. My email is Wiley Wiley, that's W-I-L-E-Y-W-I-L-E-Y, Wiley Wiley at att.net. Wiley Wiley at att.net. And if you'll get that information to me and to my producer, we'll do everything we can to help you promote this movie, because we know it's going to promote folks coming to know Jesus as Lord and Savior. And that's the greatest need in our nation and literally in our world today.
I agree, Wiley. Your producer, you'd ask me to call in tomorrow morning. Do you want me to do that?
Yeah, call in tomorrow morning. I tell you what, let me give you another number to call in on tomorrow morning just to make sure we get a good connection. We'll be on the air tomorrow. Where are you located?
I'm in Los Angeles.
Okay, well, we're on at 9 o'clock tomorrow morning. And the number, another number you can call on, an 800 number, is 1-800-839-3002. Call in right after 9 o'clock, and we'll cover this again. In the meantime, get us everything you can in the email to us, would you please?
I will. Wiley, send me your email address one time.
ATT, like the phone company, .net. So it's Wiley Wiley at ATT.net. All right, and also to Corey Harkins at yahoo.com, and we'll do our best to help you promote this thing in every way that we can.
Thank you. And how do you spell Corey's last name?
Harkins, H-A-R-K-I-N-S. And since you're in L.A., you know where Knott's Berry Farm is?
Yeah.
Okay, we're just up the street from Knott's Berry Farm at the First Southern Baptist Church. That's where my studio is. If you'd like to come in the studio, I have an open studio policy. You can come in and not only be on the air, but be on camera with me as well. Okay, we'll work that out with Corey. Her phone number is 714-470-9225. She's local. She's here. And we'd love to have you come in the studio. Well, David, we'll do everything we can to help you, my brother. You're right on target as far as we're concerned. I am Israeli by spiritual birth, even though I'm a Native American. I mean, a born American, not a Native American, but a born American. But anyway, we're behind you 100%, and we want to help you.
Thanks, sir.
Okay, David. David Wood, thank you so much. God bless you. Look forward to hearing from you tomorrow.
Sounds great, guys.
God bless. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that was David Wood, and the website is resurrectionproject.com or myresurrectionproject.com, and it's going to be shot in Israel. It's going to be a movie called Resurrection. I had heard about it, but that's the first other news that I had, so we hope to have him on again tomorrow, and then maybe Corey can later bring him into the studio with us. Do we still have the lady on from New York?
Yes.
All right, ma'am. Obviously, you can see today's show's getting kind of busy. I think I've given you Corey's name and phone number and email. All the information you can get to her will be available to anyone that wants to use it, especially folks like Bill Windsor at Lawless America and others that are fighting this terrible, terrible thing. And there's one other reason why I'm upset. First of all, I'm upset that children get taken away from families and not given back, even though the families get their act together. Now, I'm not here to say anyone should have their children if they're abusing them, and we certainly realize that. But most of them, even if they've been abused, get their act together, jump through the hoops, turn their lives around, get rehabilitated, get resurrected, if you will, and then they still won't give them their kids back. So that bugs me. And it also bugs me that the death rate is very high, very, very unusually high in foster children because they're neglected so much in foster homes. Now, I'm not saying that all foster parents are bad, My wife and I were foster parents for many years, and we weren't bad parents. We weren't perfect, but we weren't bad. But I do know there are many of them. They're in it for the money only, and they're very bad parents. So that irritates me. And it also irritates me that families get their act together, jump through the hoops, and still don't get their kids back. And there's one other reason that it makes me angry is that the money that's used to pay these court people, to pay these child protective people, that money comes out of my bank account. Now,
that's the thing that we were talking about, because what they are slated to get this year, our county alone, is $1,666,000 to put toward these things.
And let me tell you what happened a couple of years ago. Right now, I'll be 69 years old in November. But when I turned 65, I'm still working, I'm still healthy, and I did not apply for my Social Security. But the man that does my taxes called me and said, Wiley, you qualify, you better go ahead and draw your Social Security. And I said, why? And he said, well, they're going broke. And the reason they're going broke is the money that's used to pay these agencies is coming out of Social Security funds. And that is not the government's money. That's my money. The government didn't put it in there. I put it in there. Over the years, every time I worked, I paid Social Security, and it went in my account. And he told me, you better go ahead and draw it now, because Social Security is broke, going more broke, and pretty soon you won't get a check from Social Security. You'll get an IOU. So you better get it while you can. Now, that's the other reason that people who don't even have children, who might not be as concerned about kids as I am, they need to understand if you're over 65 years old, they're taking your money out of your account and they're giving it to government agencies to abuse these children. And that's the truth. We can prove that. We've done it over and over and over again. And we need some politicians that have a little guts that'll stand up.
Now, a friend of mine recently learned her children were placed in foster care for 4 years. She got them back 2 years ago.
Yeah.
She had recently learned both her daughters were molested while in this foster home.
Well, that happens quite often. We find out because we have a homeless shelter here, and because we help people like those, we find out quite often when especially teenagers come in and... And the lady that's here right now is not a teenager, though. She, that's Marge. She's a teenager. She's like me. She's a teenager. She's over 65, but she loves the Lord. Thank you so much for coming in, being in the studio. God bless you, Marge. And we're praying for you. Amen. We sure are. God bless you. Thank you. All right, now, you're absolutely right. There are many cases where they manage, when we tell tales and when we tell on people, sometimes they back off and realize they need to give the kids back, and they do sometimes. But unfortunately, in many cases, they owe the government a lot of money because they've received that money for so long. And so
that's very true.
This is a tragic, tragic phenomenon, if you will, that's going on in our nation, and we must stop it. And the only way to stop it is to expose it. That's why we call it on the Wiley Drake Show an expose of Family Services and CPS. So you have my assistant's name and phone number. If you need prayer, you call her. She is a very compassionate, loving woman, and she will be glad to pray with you and pray for you. But again, there's very little that we can do to help you other than pray with you and pray for you and load this data up to people like Lawless America and others around the country. And we're doing everything we can to help, because we believe putting it on this program on a daily basis. When we started off, we were only doing CPS one show a week, and now we're dealing with it almost every show, and we'll continue to do that. So get
there,
those.
One thing that I would like to ask, if at all possible, as Bill is on the road,
Go ahead.
As he's on the road, he could use volunteers for locations that he's coming to for each state. If anybody would be willing, please track his website and get him any assistance that might be available to help him film.
Well, we certainly do agree with you there. I travel to Washington, D.C. quite often. I travel myself quite often. I pastor a very small church, so I don't have any kind of travel budget. So when I travel, I have to travel at my own expense. And when I just recently spent over a week in D.C., a dear, dear friend, new friend, put myself and my associate up in her home absolutely free to us. And because the hotel rooms are about $250 a night in D.C., and so anything anyone can do, it's called lawlessamerica.com. Bill Windsor, help him out. And if there's anything, if you want to give him my phone number, let me give you, and I'll give it to anybody on the air, my personal cell phone number. Is area code 714-865-8132. That's 714-865-8132. And the reason I give that number out is quite often in the middle of the night sometimes I get a call from someone who has lost their children or their grandchildren, and they know that I can't do anything, quote, to help them in the world sense, but I can pray with them and for them, and I am willing to do that. That's why I put out my personal cell phone number, and that cell phone is with me at all times, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. I don't say that to brag. I just say it to make the fact. And if you want to give that cell phone to Bill and tell him to call me, you're welcome to do so. In fact, I would appreciate it if you would contact him and say, Wiley Drake would like to have you on his television and radio program. And if he's anywhere near the Los Angeles area, we'll bring him into the studio. I have a prophet's room here. We'll put him up at the church. But we'd love to have him come on the show and do a show with us here on the Wiley Drake Show. And we do two shows a day. One at 9 a.m. and one at 5 p.m. That's California time now. We're on the 5 o'clock show right now in California, both on television and on radio. And the radio is crusaderadio.com. They've been broadcasting with us and for us for over 10 years. And so please try to get in touch with Bill. Please send him an email. Give him my email. My email is Wiley Wiley. That's two Wileys. Wiley Wiley, W-I-L-E-Y, Wiley Wiley, at att.net. So it's Wiley Wiley at att.net. And please give it to him or anyone else that would like to get in this fight.
Oh, I absolutely can.
And what is your first name, if you don't mind?
Diane.
Well, Diane, thank you so much for calling today. Did you lose your children?
No, I fought very hard not to lose my children, and currently I am facing a hearing in August to clear my name.
Well, I want you to know we'll be praying for you, Diane, and don't hesitate to call me or Corey. Like I said, we're not attorneys, we're not experts, but we've been doing this for a long time. And the real secret to it is taking it before the Lord, because the Bible says we all have a top-notch attorney. In the old days in England, they didn't call them attorneys. They called them advocates. That's what they referred to them as, advocates. And the Bible says you and I as Christians have an advocate with the Father, and that advocate is Jesus Christ. By the way, are you a Christian? Well, praise the Lord. I'm glad you're my sister in the Lord.
I've raised Christian and Catholic.
Amen. Well, my dear sister, the most important thing is that you know Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior. And if you haven't done that, even as a Catholic, you need to do that. You need to acknowledge that Jesus is God and acknowledge that you can't save yourself and invite him to come into your heart and into your life. and he, I promise you, will save you miraculously. So we do present that to you as well. And Diane, if there's anything else you'd like to share, please feel free to go ahead.
No, I just wanted to make sure that as Bill is traveling on his way, if anybody is willing to give a helping hand during his filming and during his travels, that would be greatly appreciated for all of us.
Well, and I want to say, ladies and gentlemen, I'm a preacher, but I practice what I preach. I preach to you, help Bill Windsor at lawlessamerica.com, and I'm going to do everything I can to help him financially, emotionally, spiritually, and otherwise. So please go to lawlessamerica.com and help him out however you can. And please have Bill get in touch with me. Thank you, Diane. God bless you, and have a great day there on the East Coast.
You too. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, that's a perfect example of what this show is all about. We are a show that deals with church fare. Welfare is ruining or has ruined our country. Welfare in the sense of entitlements that keep people from any incentive to work. But on the worst side of it, this is welfare in its worst condition, in its worst way, because they take away children without a warrant. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm not an attorney, but many, many times they take these kids without a warrant. They walk in there and say, we've got a report. Someone said, and that's the only thing they go on. They cannot take your children without a warrant. Now, we know many times they try to scare you and they try to say, well, if you don't let us have your kids, we're going to take them away from you. Well, you tell them to take a hike. Don't let them in your home. Do not let them in the door unless they have a warrant. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm not going to let a policeman from the state, I don't care whether it's local, state, or federal, I'm not going to let them in my home unless they have a warrant. And what I say to them is, when they come to me and say, well, Mr. Drake, we want to talk to you, and I simply say to them, if it is your intention to question, arrest, or detain me, I must have my attorney present. And I carry in my pocket a Legal Shield card from Prepaid Legal. And on that card it says, if it is your intention to question, detain, or arrest me, or if you intend to remove my children from my custody or serve me with a warrant, please allow me to call my attorney immediately. Most of the times, most of the stories that we have heard about kids being taken away have been taken away without a warrant. The Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals says that's illegal, and the Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals is one of the highest courts in the land. Now, they're liberal, and they're goofy as Goofy himself, Mickey's buddy. But they did rule right when it came to this issue. And that is, they said, you cannot take children away from a family without a warrant. Now, a warrant cannot be issued by Child Protective Services. A warrant must be issued, in the legal terminology, by a magistrate. Now, what does that mean? That means they cannot come in your home. Even if they think your children are being taken advantage of, the only way they can come into your home without a warrant is if they have evidence of damage to your children. And they don't have that just simply because somebody reported you. Somebody says, well, those kids are being neglected. I saw those kids with no shoes on. I saw those kids dirty and filthy. Well, that's a shame that anybody would do that to kids, but that is not a warranted intrusion. They cannot come in there and say, we're going to take your kids, without a magistrate, i.e. a judge, issuing a warrant. And if they do not have a warrant, tell them to take a hike. We were in a case recently where they said, oh, yeah, we'll get a warrant. And they went to get a warrant, and they came back with one, and it was expired, one that they had used on a previous case, and they were going to try to fake the family into believing they had a warrant. And so the husband said, may I see that warrant? And they said, no, we have one. And they said, well, I won't let you take my kids without seeing the warrant. And when he looked at the warrant, it was outdated. It didn't have their name on it. It was a warrant from a previous case. A bogus, not valid warrant is what they were trying to use. And that's the way they operate, ladies and gentlemen. Do not under any circumstance allow them to take your children. Do not allow them to take your children without a warrant. I'm going to type in a thing here, so bear with me just for a minute while I type it in. J-U-S-T-I-C. The reason I'm doing that is that if you have a situation that comes up with you, you have someone contact you and say that they indeed want to take your kids away, I'm going to give you the number of a legal organization that will help you. They will indeed help you. And let me just see here if I can come up with a telephone number for you. I'm going to try to do that here if I can. Pacific Justice Institute, if I don't find the number, Pacific Justice Institute is an organization that will help you, ladies and gentlemen. If you already have a case, don't call them because they cannot help you if you already have a case. But if they're threatening to take your kids, you tell them no way and do not let them have your children. And as soon as you send them away packing from your door, soon as you do that, then we want you to call Pacific Justice Institute. And Pacific Justice Institute is obviously here, Pacific, meaning that they're here in California. And if you need to get in touch with them, I'm searching. And Ms. Producer, if you will look under Pacific Justice Institute and see if you can find a phone number for them, I would appreciate that. I'm looking for it, but I'm not finding it. And I know it's there, but it's just a matter of finding it. And it's hard for me to talk and search at the same time. Whoops, wait a minute. Let's see. Guess go back to about. Oops, about. Where are we? It keeps going away from me. Come on.
You want a call-in number?
I want a phone number, 916 phone number, that you can find for me for Pacific Justice Institute here in California. And I keep pulling up about, and the contact goes away as soon as I pull it up. And I don't know what I'm doing wrong, but probably because we got a loose nut behind the wheel here is probably the problem. But anyway, resources. Let's see if we.
I got it.
You got it? 916.
Well, now we're talking
about Pacific Justice.
California, right?
Pacific Justice Institute. It's be a 916 area code. Okay.
796-7150.
Seven what?
Well, again, they've got two numbers here. They've got a general number, 916. That's 916-857-6900. But there is a Santa Ana number.
7150. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, that's a local number here for us in California, 714-796-7150, 7150. But their main office is up in Northern California, and that number is 916-857-6900. I would recommend you call that number. Tell them that you have an inquiry from Child Protective Services and you need a lawyer, and they will provide an attorney for you if there is not an open case already. If there's already an open case, you already have a case, they cannot take the case. But if you just have a situation where they've knocked on the door, where they've come to try to take your kids away, and you told them to go away, call 916-857-6900 and tell them that, and they will furnish you in your local area. They have thousands of attorneys around the country, and they will put you in touch with an attorney that will help you. But they cannot take every case that is already open because they don't have enough attorneys to do that. And so please, please do not let them in your home. Please do not take any paperwork from them. Please do not do anything but slam the door in their face and call 916-857-6900. The man that runs the organization is named Brad Dacus, B-R-A-D-D-A-C-U-S. He's a godly man. He's a great attorney, and he'll be glad to help you, or some of his staff will. 916-857-6900. And if you want to call a local area here in California, Southern California, it's 714-796-7150. And, Ms. Producer, when you get a chance, you need to contact Brad Dacus. We need to have him back on our program again on television. He's been on with us one other time, but we need to get him back again one of these days and see if we can get him back on. All right, ladies and gentlemen, the program has drifted over into the expose of Child Protective Services, Family Services, whatever they call it in your state. It all has different names, but it's basically a vicious, vile group of people who indeed do take your children away and your grandchildren. Tonight, when I leave this studio, I'm going to spend time with my family. I will be with my grandkids, and I love my grandkids, and my grandkids are being well taken care of. But there are many times, many situations, I have grandparents call me all the time that say, my kids, that is my daughter, my son-in-law, or whatever, they messed up and they lost their kids, my grandkids, and I want my grandkids back. They will not let them visit me. They will not let my daughter and son-in-law have them back because they've not done what they're supposed to do. Well, if that's the case, that's okay not to give the children back to the parents. But it's not okay to say to a grandparent, you're not qualified to take care of those children. And so grandparents' rights. We have some good laws in the state of California in reference to grandparents' rights. So if you're a grandparent and they're not letting you see your kids, you get you an attorney and you tell them that you demand your grandparent rights. And you get a lawyer. And you say, well, that costs a lot of money. Well, it's your kids, folks. It's worth it, whatever you have to pay. And to get a good attorney and pay him a little bit at a time, don't pay him up front, don't give him a big amount, because that makes them run away and not come back. So pay them a little bit at a time. And we encourage you, ladies and gentlemen, indeed. Pacific Justice Institute is providing an important service to people of our country by defending. I'm very grateful for what they have done. We're a team, says Dr. Laura Schlesinger. And if Pacific Justice don't fight this stuff, it's going to overwhelm us all. And that's Bill O'Reilly. I'm not a fan of Bill O'Reilly, but he is a fan of Pacific Justice Institute. Edwin Meese also has endorsed them. Dr. Laura Schlesinger has endorsed them. And, of course, Bill O'Reilly has endorsed Pacific Justice Institute. And, by the way, I encourage you, former U.S. Attorney General Edwin Meese, Pacific Justice Institute is providing an important service, he says. And that's from a former man who was in the law, a former government official. And he says Pacific Justice is doing a great job to the people of our country by defending the constitutional rights to freedom of religious expression. And Edwin Meese is the man who's endorsed them as well. And so we encourage you, check out Pacific Justice Institute. And by the way, folks, Pacific Justice Institute deserves your support. And you say, well, I don't have much money. I can't send them a big check. Send them a $5 check. Send them a $10 check. Send them a $100 check. I don't care. Send them a check. Support them so they can pay their attorneys, because the client does not have to pay. Former U.S. Attorney General Edwin Meese says that they're a good organization. They're endorsed by Laura Schlesinger and Bill O'Reilly and others. And so we encourage you to get in touch with the Pacific Justice Institute. PacificJustice.org. PacificJustice.org. Get in touch with them. Check them out. Support them. Pray with them. Pray for them. Brad Dacus runs the place. Brad Dacus is the top dog, and he is a godly, godly prayer warrior. He prays for himself. He prays for his family. He prays for Pacific Justice, and he prays for you. Godly, godly man. And I encourage you to support him with your prayers and with your money. Donate now, he says, only $1 a day, $365 a year, to become a non-voting PJI member. And that's only $365 a year if you give a dollar a day. Empowerment for business owners, Q&A with Brad Dacus, and so forth. All kinds of things there at the website. PJI, Pacific Justice Institute Attorneys blog, is there. Upcoming events, Rotary Club of Pine Grove, August the 15th, in Silicon Valley, September. Calvary Chapel in La Habra, here in our area, in October. And we want to support those folks, and we'll promote it. And I'm asking my producer to get in touch with Brad Dacus and get him to come on the air with us to help promote this saving of our children. Ladies and gentlemen, this program is the Wiley Drake Show, and we operate on the theme, do justice, love mercy, and walk humbly with God. Now, it's not a happenstance. It's not coincidental that when Micah came out to God's people and said, what doth the Lord require of thee, but to do justice, love mercy, and walk humbly with God. Now, I'm here to tell you, folks, it wasn't coincidental that the number one thing on the top of the list was justice. And then when Jesus talked over in the New Testament, when he talked about what should be done, he talked about religion, and he said, hey, it's great that you folks have been very religious. You know, Jesus wasn't against religion. And if you're one of those nuts out there, I mean one of those loose cannons, one of those nuts who don't believe in denominationalism, who don't believe in the church, who believes that it's all bad, then you're just a nut and you're out of line. Now, I know denominations aren't perfect. They're made up of imperfect people. But I want you to know, folks, we need to work together and we need to share together. And I'm encouraging you to do that. Get behind any denomination that is standing for the family. But Jesus said, in fact, the matter is, don't take Wiley Drake's word for it. What did Jesus say? Jesus said to them there in Matthew 23:23, you were very religious. And then he went on to say, and you ought to have been. You ought to have been. He said, you tithe off of the anise and the cumin in the kitchen. That was tithing off of the very spices in the kitchen. And what most people don't realize is anise and cumin was a very expensive spice. We'd be in deep trouble here in California if we didn't have cumin. The product called cumin, if you walk into a Taco Bell or Del Taco or any Mexican restaurant, you know that pungent smell that you get when you go in and there's Mexican food being prepared? That pungent flavor, that pungent smell is not chili powder. Chili powder has no smell. The pungent flavor that you smell when you walk in a Mexican food restaurant, that smell is ground cumin. So we'd be out of luck in California if we didn't have cumin. So cumin is important. It was important in Jesus' day. In fact, he said, you guys have been so good that you've tithed off of the cumin and off of the spices in the kitchen. And you know what Jesus said? You ought to have done that. You ought to have done that. But he said, you left out the most important thing. The most important thing, he said, is justice, mercy, and faith. The same three components that Micah had said hundreds and hundreds of years before, Jesus said, do justice, love mercy, and walk humbly with God. And he said those are the most important things to do. That's why on this program, we have the expose of taking children away because of the injustice that's being done. There are two great injustices in America today. There are many more, but they're two of the greatest. The greatest injustice done to children is the fact that so many of them have been brutally murdered in their own mother's womb. And when we started killing babies, and I refuse to use the A word, I'm sorry, I'm not going to use it. I have some black American friends, and I refuse to use the N word. But I refuse to use the A word because it's not an A word. It's killing a baby. You can dress it down. You can make it sound pretty by using an A word, but it's still killing a baby. And it's wrong, folks. You don't have to be a smart guy to figure out killing babies is wrong. Doesn't matter what the circumstances are. Killing a baby is wrong with a capital R. Now, I know I misspelled that, and it's spelled with a W, but you get my point. It's wrong to kill a baby, period. Period, it's wrong to kill a baby. And that's the greatest injustice in our nation today. And the second greatest injustice in our nation today is the taking of children away from their family for money. And that's the reason they're doing it. Oh, they go to court and they claim they're doing it for the benefit of the children. And that may happen a few times, but most of the times that kids are taken away, most of the times that kids are taken away. Did you hear what I said? Most of the times that kids are taken away, it's not for what's better for the kids. It's what's for better for social services, and it has to do with money. There was an old saying back in a movie, show me the money, show me the money. Well, show me the money and you'll find out why they're taking our kids away. The second greatest injustice in America today is taking children away from their parents. The first great injustice is killing those babies, no matter what the circumstances are. There are many other injustices, and we stand against those as well. There is one injustice that's not only coming against our nation, but coming against our seniors as well. And by the way, I'm a little touchy about seniors because I are one. You know, I saw a bumper sticker the other day. It said, I 2 weeks ago, I didn't know how to spell attorney, and it was spelled wrong. And then it said, and now I are one. But the point I'm trying to make, folks, is we need to understand what's going on in this nation. We've got Obamacare. They can call it HHS. They can call it whatever they want to. But you can call it a silk purse if you want to. But if it's a sow's ear, it ain't never going to be a silk purse. You can call it whatever you want to, but it's still Obamacare. And it's Obamascare. And I'm here to tell you it's bad. And I'm here to tell you we need to fight it, and we're going to fight it. But the first injustice is killing babies. The second injustice is taking babies away from their parents for money. And the third injustice is trying to kill our seniors and try to put this Obamacare on us to cause our people to lose their religious freedom in America. That's why we're fighting, folks. That's why we're here. If you'd like to be a part of this fight, there's several phone numbers I'm going to give you. We only have about 6 minutes left, but there's several phone numbers I'm going to give you. 5 minutes from now, we're going off the air. But let me tell you, there are several phone numbers. One is 559-592-5961. The other is 800-839-3002, and there's that one. Good afternoon and welcome to the Wiley Drake Show. You're live on the air with us. Go ahead.
Oh, hi. What is this show about?
Well, the show's about the injustices in America, where babies are being killed and where babies are being taken away from families, and all the other injustices that are coming about from our government.
Yeah, I experienced that recently with my daughter's kids. She did everything they asked, you know, CPS, and they didn't give her baby back, and now she's on drugs, and I'm having a hard time, and she's having a hard time dealing with it.
Well, that's what we've been talking about. They're taking these kids away from these families, maybe because the parents were on drugs, but even after they get off drugs, even after they get all their life squared away, they still keep the kids because it's about the money. They get the money.
Yes, it's about the money because my daughter wasn't on drugs, and she followed the rules. She acted accordingly in court, and when they took the kids, that's when she got on drugs. And I blame the system for that.
Well, you're absolutely right, my dear, and it's easy for you or I or somebody else to say, oh, it's too bad that woman got on drugs. If they took my kids away from me and I couldn't do anything about it, I might go back to alcohol and drugs myself, you know.
Yeah, I don't condone it, but I understand her pain and I understand why.
Absolutely. Well, ma'am, let me do this. Let me give you a couple of names and phone numbers, and if you'd like to share your story with us, we'd be more than happy to receive it. My producer here is a lady by the name of Corey, C-O-R-I, Harkins, H-A-R-K-I-N-S. Her email is coreyharkins@yahoo.com. You send her the story. We'll be glad to put it in our databank. We'll be glad to use it in every way that we can. And we'll be glad to pray with you and pray for you. You can reach Corey on 714-470-9225. Ma'am, we're running out of time. Only got about 2 minutes left. Anything else you'd like to share?
No, that's it. I just think that they can go about taking those kids and giving them back in a better way because they get traumatized.
Amen. You're absolutely right, ma'am, and that's what we're working on. Call back anytime. We'd love to have you call back on this 800 number. And God bless you, and thank you for being on the program with us today.
All right, thank you.
And God bless you.
Okay, bye.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, there's a lady that called by accident. You see how prevalent this thing is with these children being taken away? I don't know why she called. I don't know what her initial call was all about. I have no idea. But I do know this. When she found out what we were talking about, she acknowledged that indeed her child had her children taken away. What a tragedy. What a tragedy. What a great injustice. Ladies and gentlemen, please call. Before you get a case working, please call 916-857-6900. That's Pacific Justice Institute. There's also a 714-796-7150. Ladies and gentlemen, we need your help. We need your help to expose. We need your help. We need your stories. We need your data. We need names. There's an old saying that we had in the South. People say, what have you been doing? He said, I've been taking names and kicking butt. Well, we're taking names and we're trying to kick a little butt here, folks. We need the names of your public pretenders. That's those guys that have a law degree that they say they're going to defend you. You're a public defender, and they're nothing more than public pretenders. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I only have 1 minute left, and then I got to get out of here. May the Lord bless you. May God help you. Remember, my cell phone number is 714-865-8132. Corey's cell phone number is 714-470-9225. Corey's email is Corey Harkins, CoriHarkins, CoriHarkins@yahoo.com. Mine is Wiley, WileyWiley@att.net. Give us a call. Let us know what's on your mind. Let us help you. God bless you and have a great, great day as you serve the Lord. Please allow us the privilege to pray with you and for you. Tomorrow morning, our prayer line will be open, 712-432-1690, access code 399-430-pound. God bless you. Pray with us tomorrow morning at 5 a.m. California time. Good night and God bless.